Shut up and sit down.
Light pollution speech. Speech on light pollution for students and children in English. In today's disrupted environment, light pollution has become a serious threat, particularly to nocturnal wildlife, that is, animals living in the dark. Light pollution has many negative impacts on plant and animal physiology. It can bewilder the translocating patterns of animals, change fierce interaction of animals, alter predator-prey relations, and cause harm physiologically. The rhythm of life is arranged by the natural non-nocturnal patterns of light and dark. So, disruption to these patterns affects the ecological dynamics. You will be surprised to know that with more than half of the world's population now living in cities, 3 out of every 4 people in cities have never experienced the astonishing thing of natural dark skies. Concerning bad health effects, many species, especially humans, depend on natural body cycles, which are known as circadian rhythms. They are dependent on the production of melatonin, which is regulated by light and dark also. If humans are exposed to light while sleeping, the production of melatonin can be put down. This less production of melatonin can lead to various sleep disorders and other health-related problems, such as increased headaches, worker fatigue, medically defined stress, different forms of obesity due to lack of sufficient amount of sleep, and increased anxiety. And there are risks of a couple of types of cancer. There are also bad effects of flame on aging eyes. Health effects are not caused by only over-illumination or excessive exposure to light over time, but also the inappropriate insubstantial composition of light. This composition of light is certain colors of light. If we talk about the wastage of energy, we must know that lighting is blameworthy for at least 1/4 of all electricity consumption around the world. Over-illumination can comprise energy wastage, especially in an upward direction of lighting at night. Wastage of energy is also a waste in cost and carbon footprint. The good news is that light pollution can be reduced quite easily by protecting lights properly. We should only use a light when and where it is needed. By only using the required amount, by using energy-efficient bulbs, and by using bulbs with appropriate spectral power distributions for the task at hand, we can easily reduce light pollution. Speaking with my clinical knowledge, the 3 main types of light pollution include glare, light trespass, and sky glow. Glare from unprotected lighting is a threat to the health of human beings, especially the older you become. Glare light breaking up in the eye can cause loss of contrast and it can build you temporarily. This glare leads to unsafe driving conditions, for instance. Light trespass is caused when unwanted light enters one's property. For example, we can say shining unwanted light into a bedroom window of a person who is trying to sleep is light trespass. Sky glow is defined as the glow effect that can be seen over populated areas. Sky glow is a combined form of all the reflected light an upward direction light escaping up into the sky. If we shield lights, then it can significantly reduce all 3 of these types of light pollution.